Factsverse presents. Oktoberfest could get banned after experts study its effects. Many of our time-honored traditions revolve around holidays. At Christmas, we put up a tree. On Thanksgiving, we eat turkey. On Easter, we hide eggs. One very popular tradition in Germany is Oktoberfest. People from all over the world attend to enjoy a liter of beer. Recently, experts have been suggesting that it's a dangerous tradition. Oktoberfest might actually get banned after experts have studied its effects. Before we get into our video, though, jump down to the comments and let us know what your favorite holiday is. Me? Halloween, no question. Also, be sure to subscribe and click the notification bell so you don't miss our future videos. Oktoberfest was first held back in 1810. It was a wedding celebration for Bavaria's Prince Ludwig. It was such an important event that for 10 days people danced and drank. It's been over 200 years since that first Oktoberfest, and 6 million people attend every year. There are many events that take place at Oktoberfest each year that keep people coming back. There is a stein holding competition that lets brave competitors show off their muscles. Whoever holds the stein the longest is the winner. The outfits are also kind of interesting. The women wear traditional Fräulein-style dresses, and they wear their hair in intricate braids. Men wear lederhosen. Everybody can be seen walking around carrying a stein filled with German ale. With 6 million people packed into a space for days of drinking, you can expect a few problems. Every year, medical professionals treat hundreds of thousands of festival attendees. There is a medical tent at the festival, and in 2018, one report stated that a drinker was treated in the tent every 10 minutes. Most of the people who went to the medical tent were treated for dehydration and alcohol poisoning. Those are some serious issues, but they are not what has the festival making news right now. Pollution is a problem that is caused during Oktoberfest. There's a lot of litter and waste found on the ground. And this isn't the only pollution problem. There are also jokes about gas causing problems. People burping up beer for 10 days, that's a lot, but it's not the primary concern. The methane emissions coming from Oktoberfest are 10 times higher than what the city of Boston produces at the same time. Human bodily functions only make up about 10% of the 3,300 pounds of gas that's detected, though. There's another cause for the excessive amounts of methane gas. Germans love their sausages, and sausage is served a lot in Oktoberfest. During the entire event, over 8,000 pounds of sausage is served. They have to cook the sausage before serving it, and small gas grills are used. These grills create poor air quality, and they're very harmful to the ozone layer. The two primary gas levels that have concerned the experts are methane and carbon dioxide. They're both very dangerous to the environment, and also to people. According to the experts, carbon dioxide lasts longer, but methane gas warms up the atmosphere much faster than carbon dioxide. According to an expert named Zhai Chen, Oktoberfest significantly adds to our already burning ozone layer. Zhai tracked every square meter of the festival and determined that it produces 6.7 micrograms of methane per second. The biggest issue is that people aren't aware of this problem. According to him, large, limited festivals are sources that aren't accounted for in existing emission inventories. For people to make the right decisions, inventories need to be accurate, according to Zhia. You'd think that grilling at a festival for 10 days just once a year would have a minimal effect on the environment, but Zhia's data shows otherwise. Now, nobody's saying that participants should stop grilling altogether. They should just do it more responsibly. Rather than using gas grills, the people serving the sausage could use electric grills. That would reduce methane output. The people of Germany and those who attend Oktoberfest would be very unhappy if it were canceled for good. If people are more responsible during the 10-day event, though, it could make a significant difference in the environment. In light of the information gathered during Oktoberfest, other major festivals are being analyzed for their environmental impact. There are places around the world, like China, where the smog is so thick that it's difficult to even see on a clear day. It's so bad that a fake skyline has been set up for tourists to take photos there. No kidding. The real skyline is just too foggy. On many days, it's not even safe to go out of the house without a mask in China. Even the water in China is contaminated. One of China's rivers is so polluted, it looks as if the river is made of blood. In time, more bodies of water are expected to fall to the same fate. German experts don't want something like that to happen as a result of Oktoberfest. What do you think? Should we change the way we do festivals around the world? Let us know in the comments and subscribe for more.